अस्सलाम वालेकुम, आई एम सुम्बुल ज़हरा, लेक्चरर इन फिज़िक्स एट सर सैयद गवर्नमेंट गर्ल्स कॉलेज, विद द सपोर्ट एंड गाइडेंस ऑफ आवर वेरी ऑनरेबल प्रिंसिपल प्रोफेसर खालदा परवीन। टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू डिलीवर माय 18th लेक्चर ऑफ BCS फिज़िक्स फर्स्ट सेमेस्टर कोर्स, विच इज़ ऑन द टॉपिक ऑफ डिस्प्लेसमेंट करंट। लेट्स स्टार्ट विद आवर टॉपिक विच इज़ डिस्प्लेसमेंट करंट। In my previous lecture, I have told that there is a quantity in Ampere's law, which I told this is displacement current. There is a wonderful phenomena called displacement current. So far, our definition of electric current says that whenever charged particle moves in a conductor or wherever charged particle is moving, then it makes electric current. And we had all our calculations based on that drift velocity. But then we have studied many effects of the electric current, like heating effect, magnetic effects, chemical effects and thermal effects, etc. One of the effect was magnetic effect. That is one of the most useful effect. What does it says? An electric current creates magnetic field around it. And after that, so many things. The fundamental is electric currents make magnetic field around it. What is an electric current itself made of it? It is made of moving charge particles. So current generate magnetic field. Moving charges make electric current, then charge is always carried by particles. We have studied all these things. Now, an experiment was done by Maxwell in 1860s around. So what is the experiment? It is a simple experiment that you have seen in diagram. There is a current flowing in a circuit and there is a capacitor connected here, where there is no medium between it. So it is disconnected here. Now where it is connected, if we put a magnetic needle, it deflects. Then we place that magnetic needle between capacitor, it also deflects. When the current is switched off, then according to Ampere's law, if a magnetic field is made between capacitor, then we made an Amperean loop. If there is no current, then no magnetic field. Now, if I place a magnetic needle between capacitor, it deflects. And it deflects because of the presence of magnetic field. When we switched it off, it does not deflect or displaced. The moment we switched it on, it is displaced. Then we apply Ampere's law. If there is a magnetic field, then current is flowing through the loop. If there is a loop, then there should be current. And this current will produce this, what said by Ampere's, magnetic field. And if there is no current, there is no magnetic field. And for the current, we need charges to move. And for the charges, we need material. And here is no material between capacitor. If there is no material, there is nothing which will carry the charges. And if there is nothing to carry the charges, then charges cannot move. If the charges cannot move, then there is no current. And if there is no current, then there will be no magnetic field. But we find there is a magnetic field. This is the controversy, and this was the big question at that time, that how the current passes through this capacitor when there is no material and no charges there. And it is sure that current is passing because we are saying magnetic field is there. And this was the problem which was built by Maxwell, and he gave us the concept, the new concept, that our thinking is not sufficient. We said that current creates magnetic field, moving charges make current. This is not sufficient. Who told that only moving charges make current, nothing else cannot make current? That was the problem. Whom do you call current? Current is the one which creates a magnetic field around it. If it is true, then it is not moving charges can create a magnetic field, but something else can also create a magnetic field. And that something else is acting as same duty what a current is doing. What is that something else? He said that something else exists here between capacitor where there is no charges, no particles, no current. But there is current made by something else which creates magnetic field. And that current which is not made by moving charges or by conduction of particles, but it is doing the same job as another current is doing. He gave it a name, displacement current. So, displacement current is that current which is doing the job of the normal current, and this current is known as conduction current because the charge particles are conducting. So, between capacitor there is a current because magnetic field is created there, and this I call displacement of conduction current, or in short it is called displacement current. Then he explained what is the nature, what is the description. He says it creates electric field between capacitor, and this electric field keep on varying. So there is an electric field between it, and it keeps on changing. And he says that this varying electric field, which we call dE by dt, is acting as an electric current between it. And for the presence of electric field, we don't need any material, we don't need any particle, we don't need any travel of particles, nothing. Just vacuum or space only, where electric field can vary. When it is there, it will create magnetic field there. So this changing of electric field act as a current, and I will call it a displacement current, which is known as ID equals to epsilon naught d phi e by dt. Because at either place IC is present or ID is present, it has to be same because it is in the same circuit. So ID can do any effect here. It creates magnetic field. So in Ampere's law we can write close integral B dot dl equals to mu naught I, which is equals to mu naught IC plus ID. So closed integral B dot dl equals to mu naught IC plus mu naught, putting the value of ID, which is epsilon naught d phi e by dt. So it is modified Ampere's law, which we called Ampere's Maxwell law, where phi e equals to e dot a. So equation become close integral B dot dl equals to mu naught IC plus mu naught epsilon naught dE dot a by dt, which is known as modified Ampere's law, which we call Ampere's Maxwell law, in which ID equals to epsilon naught d phi e by dt, which is displacement current. So that's all for today. Thank you so much.